Australia is located in the southwestern Pacific. It's larger than the mainland of America, when excluding Alaska. One of the most urbanized nations in the world, 85% of the population live within 30 miles of the coast, since the entire center of the country is either arid or desert. It's the driest continent on Earth. Located in the vast empty middle is a massive sandstone monolith known as Ayres Rock. Surrounded by hundreds of miles of desert, it's estimated to have formed around 600 million years ago and originally sat at the bottom of the sea. Today, it stands 1,140 feet above the desert, over 2,800 feet above sea level, and has a circumference of 5.8 miles. This is one giant rock. Ayres Rock and the Olgas, a group of large dome rock formations 16 miles to the west, are part of a national park. The entire park is considered sacred to the Aboriginal people. Australia has some very interesting animals. The koala is one of the most popular and is only found in Australia. They exclusively eat eucalyptus leaves. In fact, they eat so many they smell like a leaf. They're related to kangaroos and have pouches where they carry their babies. The echidna has spines like a porcupine, beak like a bird, pouch like a kangaroo, and lays eggs like a reptile. It appears to have been put together by a dysfunctional committee, also known as a spidey anteater. It's only one of two known mammals known to lay eggs. And not to be upstaged, there's the platypus, with a bill like a duck, a tail like a beaver, and feet like an otter. Sounds like something a mad scientist would create. Add the ability to lay lizard-like eggs and shoot poison out of their rear feet, you have a very unique creature. They are small and shy, but not always.
I'm a platypus. I'm a platypus.
Wombats have very short muscular legs and are the closest relative to the koala. They are the only animal who can produce square poop. Dingoes are wild dogs found in Australia and the country's largest predator. Australia's little penguins are curious creatures. Are often grooming themselves or each other. The wallaby is a small kangaroo. And they like ice cream cones. The iconic kangaroo is the unofficial symbol of Australia. They are identified by their muscular tails, strong back legs, large feet and pointed ears. Females have pouches that contain mammary glands, where their young live until they are old enough to emerge. And they are tough fighters. Australia has nearly 900 varieties of birds. With the emu, the best known native, while the females are not very attractive. The male is very colorful. The northeast coast has some of the most beautiful landscapes. scenic beaches. Lots of birds. Bats. Busy spiders. And a strategically placed church window.
I've heard there was a secret chord that David played and it played.
150 miles south of Australia is Tasmania, which is part of the Australian Commonwealth. It's known for its beautiful countryside, scenic valleys, and unique cave formations at Gunns Plains. But it's best known for being home to the Tasmanian devil. It's a marsupial related to koalas and kangaroos, the size of a small dog, but with a large head and neck, which allows it to generate among the strongest bites of any land predator. And they like taking naps. Australia is also home to the Great Barrier Reef, the world's largest coral reef system. It's composed of over 2,900 individual reefs, 900 islands, and stretches for over 1,400 miles. It's a wonderland with over 600 types of hard and soft coral. Hundred varieties of fish, little black attack fish, including the one Disney made famous, the clownfish. And big friendly man, always coming around to check things out. There are giant clams, some weighing over 450 pounds. These bottom feeding behemoths have an average lifespan of around 100 years. The colors are stunning. Australia is a huge country with beautiful scenery, vast desert, unique animals, and the breathtaking Great Barrier Reef. If you're interested in travel to Australia, go on an African safari. Or a tour of Polynesia. Contact Elaine Randolph at the following numbers. She's a professional travel consultant who specializes in custom travel adventures.